rolling right here. This is the last time that we're going to say, rise, oh God.
Rise, oh God.
Real simple, y'all, and take your place. We've come to give you glory. You got it.
God, for another Sunday that He's blessed us to come together to be able to share the word of the Lord. I thank God for this opportunity to be able to minister unto you today, and I pray that God flows in the Spirit and that you'll be able to obtain something that will help you in your everyday Christian walk. Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you today for affording us the opportunity to be able to serve you one more day and to be able to lift up your name and give you glory and give you praise and give you honor. And we thank you for the opportunity to be able to minister and be a vessel for you. And we ask that the words that come out of my mouth be beneficial to someone today, that it may renew their walk with you. We ask all these things in your name. Amen. Praise God. Today I'm going to be talking about we are essential. God wants you to know that you are essential. You're extremely important to Him. What does essential mean? It means that you're absolutely necessary. You're extremely important. You're important to God today. And in this pandemic, we've heard about people dying from the COVID-19. We have known people who have died from the COVID-19. Every day, the news is reporting on the COVID-19, its effects, the numbers, the lockdowns, the mask wearing, and determining what things are essential and necessary for the people. What things they think we need to have access to, and how much we need of certain things. Essential, necessary, valuable. Well, God wants you and me to know today we are essential to Him. We are necessary today. He is not concerned about your history. He is not concerned about your past. He is not concerned about what your reputation used to be. Keep that in mind, what your reputation used to be. He is not concerned about what you don't have. He's not concerned about what you do have. He can and He will use you to help, to restore, and deliver. You are essential. And out of your obedience, if you will surrender your will to Him, He will restore unto you whatever you've lost, whatever you feel that you so desired and didn't get, He will restore that unto you. Today I want to talk to you briefly about a man named Zacchaeus. Some of most of you know the story of Zacchaeus. So let's go to Luke 19, beginning at verse 1. Then Jesus entered and passed through Jericho. Now behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus, who was a chief tax collector, and he was rich. And he sought to see who Jesus was, but could not because of the crowd, for he was of short stature. So he ran ahead and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was going to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and saw him and said to Zacchaeus, "Make haste and come down, for today I must stay at your house." So he made haste and he came down and he received him joyfully. But when they, we all know some people that are theys in our lives right now. Don't fear them. They have no power. The theys don't have any power. They all, when they saw him, they all complained, saying, "He was gone to be a guest with a man who was a sinner." Being critical about who Jesus is choosing to spend his time with. He being Jesus, they're being critical about who Jesus is choosing to spend his time with. But what they did not know was that Jesus had a need of this man to get some work done for others, to restore. Zacchaeus was essential to Jesus at this present time. You see, what looks essential to you may not be in line with what Jesus' view, how he sees someone, how he sees something. So verse 8 in Luke 19 says, "And then Zacchaeus stood and said to the Lord, 'Look, Lord, I give half of my goods to the poor. And if I have taken anything from anyone by false accusation, I restore fourfold.'" Repentance is what Zacchaeus was doing at that moment. He was repenting. This is important in being essential to Christ. Willingness is important. Zacchaeus was willing in being essential, in being necessary, in being in this army of the Lord. Verse 9 says, "And Jesus said to him, 'Today salvation has come to this house, because he also is a son of Abraham. He was talking about Zacchaeus. He now belongs, no matter what he may have done in his past. Jesus forgave him. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. This passage of scripture comes to encourage us today to renew our outlook on who Jesus is, how he views us, and his everlasting and continued grace and mercy toward us. We should be giving God a praise at this moment because we've already heard an encouraging word so far. Jesus has need of us. Say that with me. Jesus has need of me. Jesus has need of me. So no matter what you may have gone through, no matter what you may have lost, no matter what others may have said about you, no matter what they have accused you of, said you did, no matter if people tried to steal your self-worth, no matter if you tried to tell yourself, I am not worth it, no matter. No matter if you try to tell yourself you're too old, doesn't matter. Say, I am worth it. I can make it. Let somebody else do it. These are the things we try to say, but turn that around. No matter what you may have done in the past, God wants you to know right now. He wants you to know today you are essential to him. Yes, you're essential to him. I'm essential to him. You don't have any money right now to get things, you're still essential to him. You don't have any finances to do what you need to do, but you want to try, God can still use you. Say essential. I'm essential. I'm essential to Christ. I'm necessary. The Lord has need of me even right now. Even in the time where I may be lacking, God still has need of me. What are the qualities and necessities of being an essential worker? Be determined, be steadfast, and unmovable. Psalms 46 and 10 says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. Follow God. He will do the work. He said, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. No matter how much faith you have, he says, I will be exalted. I will cause things to come to pass. I will be lifted up. Isn't that a wonderful thing to know that you're working for a God that is going to always come through? Be mindful. What does that mean? Being aware of your thoughts, your emotions, and how you're feeling. So how are we thinking about our Lord and Savior right now? Are we trusting him as the Lord of our lives? Are we unbalanced at times because we are not sure of how it is all going to turn out? Be mindful. Control your thoughts. Ask God to help you in this area. Why? Because the devil is a mind worker. He will cause you to lose focus, become afraid, give in, say, what's the use? Be mindful. Say, be mindful. Be on top of it. Stay prayed up. Stay fasted up. The scripture, Isaiah 26 and 3 says, thou will keep him or her or them in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee, whose mind is stayed on God because he trusts in you. Do you? Are you trusting? Take a moment to ask yourself, am I trusting? Who am I trusting in? Am I trusting in God? Do you want to be essential? Then we must. If your answer to that question, do you want to be essential? Then you must. We must. We have to stay focused. More so now than ever before. Be an encourager. Has God ever commanded you to encourage someone else while you're going through? While you're waiting on your deliverance? 1 Corinthians 15 and 58 reads, therefore, my beloved brothers, sisters, be steadfast. Don't give up. Be immovable. And then it says, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. It is not in vain. It says, know this, whatever you do for the Lord, it is not in vain. It is not for naught. Why is that? Because God has need of you. God has need of you, just like he had need of Zacchaeus, even though the people were criticizing Jesus' choice to go and minister unto Zacchaeus, he still had need of him. He was forgiven so he could assist in restoration. And as you move forward in the commandments of God to assist someone else, to encourage someone else, deliverance for you is on the way. You just got to believe it. Just move. Just walk. Run this race with faith. If you get tired of walking, run some more. If you can't run, you may need to crawl, but stay in the race. Stay in the race. Stay in the race. It will pay off after a while. Stand on the word of God, not on the word of the media, not on the word of they say. Standing on the word of God. Read his promises. Memorize some of them so that you can encourage yourself. Pour yourself in the word. Make the word part of your characteristic. Know that you are a king's kid, a child of God. 1 John 3:1 says, behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore, the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. So don't be discouraged because people don't respect you. Don't give up. Don't quit. But rather know this, I am, you are. Kids, king's kids. We are king's kids and he needs us. This is all that matters in this walk with Christ. He needs us and we need him. Give God a praise right now. If you're not already giving him a praise, give him a praise because he's worthy to be praised. God has need of us to bring about deliverance. We walk by faith. Realize as you march in faith, God will take care of you. And he will use you and me for his glory. We walk by faith, not by sight. We must, as followers of Christ, we must believe in the things we cannot see. The things God has spoken to you about, believe it. We see people dying, still believe. We see people hurting, still believe. We see people in need, still believe. Because God's got you. Still believe in our Almighty God. He has us. We have to tell ourselves that. Who's your number one cheerleader? You should be your number one cheerleader because you're with yourself all the time. You should be your number one cheerleader, trusting in the Lord at all times. Speak as though you are convinced. Speak as though you are necessary, essential, no matter what. Say out loud, I am convinced. I know God's got me. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It just won't work, for I'm essential. Say I'm essential to be used by God. Romans 8:38-39 says, for I am persuaded. I am convinced. I believe that neither death nor COVID-19 nor COVID-19 nor life, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor things to come, nor things to come. I don't know what's coming, but I believe, I'm convinced, nor things to come. I don't know about what's coming, but I believe shall be able to separate us from the love of Christ Jesus, our Lord. I must, you must, say I must. I must be committed to the work of the Lord, even in the time of a pandemic. Committed unto death. I dare you to commit. Think, how can I become stronger in the Lord? Think about that. Do I need to repent? Think about that. Do I need to recommit? Think about that. Well, I'm saved. I've been running this race for 50 years. But that has nothing to do with the fact that you may have slipped sometime. So ask yourself, what do I need to do to become stronger in the Lord, to run this race a little bit harder? Do I need to repent? Do I need to recommit? What do I need to do to become stronger in the Lord, to continue to qualify to be essential? And then we need to trust in the Lord with all of our heart. Proverbs 3:5-6 says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall, not maybe, he shall direct thy path. He shall, he will. So why not praise him in advance? Don't lean to Joe Biden. Don't lean to Kamala Harris. Lean to Christ. We're saying, let's lean to Christ. Let's choose. Let's vote. We got to vote. Remember to vote. But put all your trust in Christ. Put all of your trust in Christ. Don't put your trust in man. Man can let you down. Put your trust in Christ. But yes, remember to vote. Remember to vote. Speak peace unto yourself. Cheer for your increase. But don't forget to thank God for maintaining you while you're waiting on him to bring you through. And listen. Listen. Still give God praise in the midst of the time of decrease. Still give God praise in the midst of the time of decrease. Still give God praise. Paul said in Philippians 4:12-14, he says, I know both how to be abased and I know how to abound. Everywhere and in all things, I'm instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I know how to make it when I don't have what I need. I know how to praise him when I got everything I need. I know how to praise him when I'm waiting on him. That's what Paul was saying. I'm good in the bad times. I'm good in the good times. I'm good in the in-between times. And guess what? Under all of those things, the bad times, the good times, the in-between times, underneath that, I'm saying I'm praising God. Until that praise that is underneath those things rises to the top and my praise becomes more important than what I'm going through. You should be praising God right now for that, because that's a powerful word. Give him a praise no matter what stage of life you are in at the present time. And when the mountains seem to be too high to climb and too hard to get over, the Bible says, speak to the mountains. In Mark 11:23, it says, verily I say unto you that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be cast into the sea, shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe. Shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe. Shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass. If I speak it, the Bible's letting me know. Speak it, and it shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he said. If you speak it, you shall have what you say. See, a lot of times we get caught up in that waiting on man to approve us, waiting on man to tell us what to do. But God is saying, speak, use your power. The Bible says that he made us, man, a little lower than angels. So what's the matter with us when we can't believe that and stand on his word and say, I have power? When the enemy comes, remember, we are made a little lower than the angels. So where is Satan? He's under our feet. We should find ourselves not saying so much how busy Satan is, but say, I am busier. I'm working on this. God's helping me. I shall rise. I'm above the devil. And when the devil gets that you got where your position is in the Lord, he will flee. The Bible lets you know he will flee, but you got to recognize where you are. So speak to the darkness that may come your way. Speak to fear, speak to depression. People say depression. We're saints, but I'm telling you, depression comes upon saints. Sadness comes upon saints. Anxiety comes upon saints, for they are mountains that try to hold us in captivity. They are mountains that try to bring us down. But let's speak to them. And when you don't have the strength to speak to them, get with a prayer warrior and say, I need you to speak a word over me. I need you to cast this spirit of depression, this anxiety down. And then realize, if you need to talk about it, ask God to lead you to a trusted person, because we need to have conversation. So, for they are mountains. Let's go. Let's be healed. Let's be delivered. Let's go and walk in Christ. I must work the works of him that sent me. That scripture, John 9:4. I understand it now. It says, I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day, while I'm still alive, while I'm breathing. When night cometh, when I die, when you die, no man can work. We've never seen a dead man get up out of the grave and start doing work, saying he needs to make money, he needs to pay his house note. That's over. But you need to work while it's day. Because when night cometh, when you die, you can't do anymore. So do what you can do now, because you're essential. We must find ourselves busy in the work of the Lord right now. So let's go. Let's find ourselves busy. Are you feeling essential yet? Are you seeing why the Lord needs you? He needs you. He needs me to do the work, to kingdom build, to draw people onto him, even in the time of trouble, in the time of this pandemic. You must continue to speak of his goodness. The world, the politics, the GOP cannot stop us as we begin to unite together and trust in the Lord. God is in control. Don't be afraid. If you are afraid, don't stay there. Anxiety is a real emotion. The symptoms of anxiety are worry, sadness, nervousness, hopelessness. But the symptoms of a believer is trust in God, hope beyond hope, steadfastness, and continued renewed faith in God. So when you feel the symptoms of anxiety, here is how you command it to leave. And if you might want to write this down, or you can rewind this tape. You want to sit down and say the following things to yourself and repeat them until you begin to rest in Jesus. You might want to think about this. Say, I am safe. God will not let harm come to me. A panic attack cannot hurt me. I am breathing in the blessings of the Lord. I am beginning to calm down. I'm going to be okay, because God has me. God has me. I am safe. God will not let harm come to me. A panic attack cannot hurt me. I am breathing in the blessing of the Lord. I'm beginning to calm down. I'm going to be okay. Say, I'm going to be okay, because God's got me. Because God's got me. Lamentations 3, verses 22 through 23. It is the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are renewed every morning. Hallelujah. They are renewed every morning. Ha! They are renewed. Thank God for his mercy. We get a new chance every morning that we wake up. Tell God right now. Tell him, I trust you, Lord. I trust you, Lord. I believe you, Lord. I will not fear man. Job said, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. But I will maintain my own ways before him. So what's it say? I have to trust him to get me out of what he allowed me to go into. He is processing us through this difficult time. Nothing happens unless God allows it to happen. He is processing us. You think he didn't know about the COVID-19? Yes, he did. You think he didn't know hundreds of thousands or a hundred and some thousand were going to pass away due to the COVID? Yes, he did. You didn't think he didn't know that people were going to lose their jobs? Yes, he did. You didn't think he didn't know that people weren't going to have money to get food? Yes, he did. Yes, he did. But what he's asking us to do today is to trust him, stretch out on him, and believe that he will bring things to pass. Don't fear any man. Don't fear any man, but rather trust God. He did not bring us this far, people. He didn't bring us this far, saints of God, to leave us. Come on and give God praise right there, knowing that he did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not. Say, he did not bring me this far to leave me. If you believe, everything's going to be all right. Tell him thank you right now. We have come too far by faith, leaning on the Lord, trusting in his holy word. He will not. The psalm says he never has failed me yet, but I say he will not fail us. He will not fail you. He will not fail me, for he has need of us. He has plans for us. Here's what we must do. More so now in this time of trouble, a time we never even imagined in our wildest thoughts or dreams. Here's what we must do in this time of pandemic, even after, and we should have been doing it before, but don't criticize yourself. Don't beat yourself down. God knows us, but let's press in. We must pray like never before. Pray more than you talk about the president. Pray more than you watch the news. This is what you have to do as an essential worker. We must always stay qualified to do the will of God. Be ready to do the work. We are soldiers in God's army. We move in the spirit. We live in the spirit. We breathe in the spirit. We are focused. We walk not by sight, essential workers, for the Lord has need of us. Give him some praise right now. Say, Lord, I thank you that you have need of me. Even in my doubt, you have need of me. Even in my fear, you have need of me. Even in my overdosing on CNN or MSNBC, Lord. And then I begin to have anxiety. You still have need of me. Hallelujah. Agree with me. Agree within yourself. Agree within your spirit. You will test positive for Jesus. Agree within yourself. When people around you, they will feel the presence of the Lord. They will scan something different about you. Always test positive for Jesus abiding in you. And be guilty of exhibiting the love of God, even with your immediate family. Let your light shine. Test positive for Jesus, even with your immediate family. Because you see, in order to continue to be essential, we must qualify. We must continue to qualify to be a servant for the work of the Lord. So are you up to the assignment today? Are you up to the assignment today? Are you ready to work in this time of pandemic? Are you up to doing the work even in this uncertainty? Even when you can't see a way out? You should be saying yes. Yes to God. Yes to his will. Yes to his way. We serve a great, big, wonderful, dependable, and everlasting God. He has us. Even when we cannot trace him, he has us. He is there. He has us. Say, he has me. He has me. Even when we feel like things are going downhill, he's asking us today to trust him because he's got you. Say, he's got me. Sometimes you have to say it out loud even though you may be the only one in the room, so you can hear your voice, which you recognize, coming back in your ears, telling you, God has you. He will take care of us. Matthew 6, 9 reads, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us, but deliver us, from evil. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. God is always in control, saints. He has us. And remember, we are essential to him. So come, agree with me, agree with yourself to continue to qualify to be essential even in this time of trouble. Say, even in this time of trouble, I will test positive for Christ. I will test positive. I will continue to qualify to be an essential worker. I hope you're saying that today, because you need to hear your voice say this. You need to hear your words coming back into your ears to become more committed. I will continue to qualify to be an essential worker for Christ. When I was growing up in the church, we would sing a song. Get your mind on Jesus. Get your mind on Jesus. We gonna have a good time. Talking about a good time, we gonna have a time. What am I saying? Get your mind on Jesus. Keep your mind on Jesus and enjoy the fact that he has you. We are essential. We are necessary. The Lord has need of us right now. Hallelujah. Right now. I know we miss being in church. I know we miss lifting up the name of Jesus together. I know we miss giving praise dances and shouting at any opportunity as the Spirit moves. And we were excited to do so. I know we miss being in church. I do. When we are given the opportunity to reassemble, we'll be excited. And I believe God has done some spectacular things for us in this time of the COVID-19. For all of us, he's done some spectacular things. Take a moment to think about that. What has he done for you lately? And we may be saving that testimony for when we return to church. But I want to encourage you today, because you're essential and you need to tell of his goodness every chance you get. I want to encourage you today to praise God for yourself. Don't save that testimony for when you assemble back in the sanctuary, but praise God for yourself. Testify to yourself. Tell of his goodness to yourself, so that you can empower yourself to keep on. Keep fighting. Encourage yourself. Testimony is necessary and essential now. You can give that testimony again as you assemble back with the saints of God. But right now, give the testimony yourself and give it to someone as God presents them in your pathway. Encourage. You can tell it, but tell it right now. Tell it right now. Know that you're essential with Christ today. Hallelujah. He needs you. He has need of you, just like Zacchaeus. Don't worry about what people say about you. Don't worry about your past. Don't worry about what anointing you don't think you have. Just start telling of his goodness. You don't need anointing to tell of his goodness. You just need to tell it. You don't need anointing to give him a praise. You just need to do it. You don't need him to raise your voice in glory. You just need to do it, because you know the kind of God. Hallelujah. You know the kind of God that you serve. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. Tell him thank you today, and begin to tell him thank you throughout the day. Tell him thank you. Tell him thank you. Claim your victory.
Claim your peace. Reclaim your joy. Hallelujah. Because God, God has need of you. Hallelujah. Even in this time of the pandemic, test positive for Christ. Praise God. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this word today. We thank you that it's going to be beneficial to someone in their walk with you. It's going to empower someone. It's going to strengthen someone. It's going to encourage someone, Lord. And we thank you right now. And we give you glory. And we give you praise. Thank God. Amen. Be blessed.